we got to talk about the man that I think is back, Trea Turner. Listen, Trea Turner was struggling since the all, since not even just the All-Star break, but because he had a great July. But it's been really bad to see him have 10 home runs in early July. And then after the All-Star break, his numbers drop. His OPS dropped 136 points in the All-Star break until Tuesday. His batting average dropped 52 points. He was not good. And he got a day off on Wednesday, you know, Grand Slam and Renee Day. And he wasn't injured or anything. He just was struggling. And so to have that day off and then come back. And on Thursday, Trea Turner went 3-for-5 with a double, 2 RBIs, 2 runs scored on Thursday, and then went 4-for-5 with the walk-off single in the ninth inning we saw Friday in that 3-2 win over the Nationals. Trea Turner had, between Thursday and Friday, 7 hits in 2 games, including a walk-off single. He also then Sunday gets his first home run. Mind you, that home run, and I had to like do a double take because I cannot believe it's been that long. That home run is the first in nearly, they said, 2 dozen games on the broadcast since July 24th versus the Twins. He hadn't had a home run in,
long time ago.
In all of August. And in terms of RBIs, he'd only had 6 RBIs on the month of August. Four of those 6 RBIs that Trea's had in the month of August came in the National Series.
Yep.
Okay, so coming into the National Series, he didn't have a home run in the month of August. He had 2 RBIs total in the month of August. And he then turned around after that day off Wednesday, explodes out in the National Series to combine for a total of 10 hits total in the series. 10 hits, 3 doubles, 1 home run, 4 RBIs, which is more than he had had all of the month prior. I know we're only a little over halfway through the month of August, but that's staggering numbers that in one series, he immediately flips after having a day off. And I want to say, Trea Turner's back.
I think that, I mean, this was a definitive get right weekend. And I shouldn't say, you know, I guess I should say series because he didn't play in the second game against the Marlins, but it was a definitive get right series. As you mentioned, 10 hits in 4 games, 4 extra base hits. The at bats were just, he never felt out of an at bat. There was a time over like late, as you mentioned, in between that home run against the Twins and him being benched, it was sub 200. Over a 4-week stretch, the at bats, like he would get into 2-strike counts and it just looked over. I think he was pulling his front foot a little bit. I think his front shoulder was kind of, because of that, was kind of checking out, and he was popping up a lot. He was pulling off of pitches and he was popping up a ton, and kind of uncharacteristically chasing a lot of stuff out of the zone. They were just peppering him with like last year Nick Castellanos type sliders, and he was obliging, and so they were just going to continue to sit down there and feast on him until he figured it out. But this weekend, Renee, he had 8 balls, and they weren't all hits obviously, but 8 times over the course of 4 games he squared up a ball at 97 miles an hour or more. His solid contact improved substantially over this weekend. The front shoulder stayed down, the hips were square, the foot was you know, up and down quickly. And I think what probably excited me the most was the fact that he was hitting with 2 strikes. I think he ended up with 3 hits just in that game, that Friday night game, the City Connect game, where he had hits with 2 strikes. And this is the portion of the show where I'm going to ask for forgiveness and not allowance. And I'm just going to do this and see what happens. Take a look at these. These are both the 2 strikes. These are his 2-strike approach. You can obviously see the pitch in the one. You can't see it in the other. Both of these ended up being base hits. What I've noticed over the last weekend was Trea Turner has simplified his 2-strike approach. Look at where his foot placement is. Now, the left picture is a little further along in the pitch sequence than the right foot is, but both of these pictures pretty much encapsulate what he did with 2 strikes this weekend. He lowered his leg kick to basically be non-existent. It became basically a toe tap because it wasn't even a pickup put down. It was more just a toe tap to get your load going, to get your engage going, and to get your plant foot where you can explode off that back hip and back foot. His two strike approach this weekend was so much better. I know that, like, you're going to be able to tell in this picture on the left, like, that's heading towards hanging breaking ball territory, and he should hit that ball hard. But the other one, you don't see a pitch. I can promise you it's a hit. There's a third picture that I just couldn't fit on the graphic. He did the same exact thing with two strikes, drove it into the outfield for another hit, because his timing is cleaner because of the fact that he, with two strikes, has eliminated the leg kick and gone to a toe tap. He's getting loaded quicker, and therefore he's not out on his, he's not trailing behind, and he's staying centered and barreling more balls because he's not lagging behind and trying to make up for it with, an out of place swing. His approach with two strikes this weekend was what excited me the most.